We decided we're going to go for a steering wheel swap, going from the RT's stock to these guys that I found actually through eBay, and one of the few times that I'm psyched to not have been ripped off by a couple of vendors that I've been ripped off by in the past, especially on Instagram. These guys are great though, been based out of Rhode Island, custom fabricated carbon-based solutions, and of course this wheel just by itself was just so unique I had to have it because it has this red awesome carbon look to it. From a glance, they are about the same size wise. I guess you could say the carbon one's got a little bit more of an aggressive race cutoff at the bottom as opposed to the factory, so it's like more compressed looking. Weight-wise, they're definitely the same, but the key thing, of course, aside from the looks, is just this grip. The grip and the overall feel of this versus factory. Factory, you have your perforated leather, sure, it's comfortable, no question there, but these guys just make it feel just kind of beefier, tougher, super comfortable grip with, you know, these finger inlays in here for sure. And then the only other heads up is, of course, for those of us with RT, with the heating element, that's what you see in here post removal. The heating element inlets to heat your steering wheel. Of course, with this, you don't get that. So it's something that we get to forego, but otherwise you kind of have this awesome, it's not even technically round. If you tried to do a cross section of this, you probably would see it's more of an oval than it is of a perfect circle like the factory one is. And you definitely notice that on the bottom part where it's almost like a rectangle with rounded edges is the feel for the bottom piece, as opposed to the more rounded approach that the factory has done. So the video, I think I referenced this, or if not, I'll reference it again. The video for taking the wheel off and putting another one on is out there. Now, I didn't do it. These guys from a competitor actually did an awesome job. Probably the best video I've ever seen, most detailed to how to remove a Durango steering wheel and put it back on. Except they're lacking maybe the technicality of the sizes of bolts that go into places, but you can figure it out. Anyway, we're going to put this back on and see what it looks like in the car, see how the drive feels.
If you didn't know, battery's on there, so we're gonna go ahead and disconnect the ground so that way we could go ahead and get started. All right, so all you need is your 10 millimeter socket, which is usually the one that you're always missing. All right, that's done. Now we could go ahead and pop out the airbag. So you're gonna grab your Allen key and you're gonna put it through the hole. Here goes one side. Here will be done on the other side. And then your airbag is out. So then you're gonna pop these two off, and then you're gonna take this off. So we're just gonna go ahead and pop these up. And then you can snap these out, and then you'll put your flathead in here. And then boom, it's out. Now we're gonna go ahead and take off these. And we're gonna proceed in unbolting the center bolt so that way we could get the steering wheel out.
This is what you're going to use to get the steering wheel bolt off. Just be real careful when you're trying to get it loose, and definitely be careful when you're trying to put it back on so it's not over torqued. So the one that I was using was a Gearhead brand, but it's an H10, you know, like one of the thickest Allen wrench sizes you could possibly get out there, with a bolt onto the wrench. You will definitely need a wrench to loosen that stuff. I've seen, you know, when you saw in the video that there's a drill being used as an attachment. I am not a fan of using drills because I like to feel it by hand and getting the right torque amounts down. So your call.
You're gonna take off the steering wheel weight. Now we're just gonna go ahead and proceed in taking off all the bolts, transfer the harness to the other steering wheel, take off the buttons, and then we should be good to go.
This is what you would use for the pedal shifter removers and the harness inside the steering wheel and a couple of additional bolts, T20 with the what I call star pattern, whatever the name of that is.
Shifters, you're gonna have two bolts. We're just gonna go ahead and take those off. Alright, now that you have your buttons off, we can just release them from their tabs. Take off these. And go ahead and pull off the bracket if you would like to. Then you have the heated option here, so we're gonna have to pop this off. So for these, you're gonna go ahead and use a super small screwdriver.
And then the little guy. Actually, one of the little guys, I believe it's a T10, is what you would use to get the back bezel off, to get the heating element out from the bottom of the steering wheel when you're taking that apart.
So you put your flathead in there and then pull it off. Now you have access to the wires of your heated option, so you're just gonna go ahead and put the flathead in here. Take that one off. And then this one is just push out. And then you have your harness out. That's it. Your OEM steering wheel is now officially uninstalled with all your buttons and harness out of the way.
All right, the wheel's been installed. Relatively painless, with very few, if any, damages. So now we're just going to fire this up, see if we're getting any cells, and drive around with this thing for a little bit. Hopefully it works out all right. Since the battery gets disconnected as part of the wheel install or replacement, I was just waiting to see if anything's going to change in any of the settings. The car is going to act any goofier or anything. I just maybe a little bit more paranoid than I needed to be, and that's okay. So let's just go and see if we can get a feel for the new wheel. Straightaway, so you can't go too nuts. We all know changing steering wheel adds at least 20 horsepower. Fact. Sarcastic. Insert sarcasm here. Please don't start sending me hate mail about how that's the dumbest statement ever. I am well aware of that. That was on purpose. Some of the trolls are definitely not going to like that one. Handling seems pretty good. The feel of the wheel is great. So far, no issues. Kind of get a nice little sheen going with reflection from the sun coming in. Again, just this, that nice feel of grips for the thumbs. There's some other steering wheels out there with the inlays that are here, and then everything else is like darker carbon. But anyway, I just thought, because the interior of this thing is obviously black on red, figured black and red steering wheel in this combo would definitely be the way to do it. So again, nice, solid, really, I think, just deserving more of a car this caliber. I mean, I didn't hate the stock wheel. I didn't think it was that bad, but still, this is just giving it that much more of a feeling that you're driving like a serious SUV truck combo, just built for having fun, not just chasing groceries. So I really am a fan of this so far. Like I said, don't seem to have too many issues. It would be interesting to see. I mean, I use the windshield screen, especially in the summer, quite a bit when I'm parked to make sure things don't get faded out. It would be interesting to see the resilience of the carbon and how it holds up against the UV impact. So I suppose we can do a review of this in a few months, or maybe, you know, say fall sometime, just to see if there's any fade, if there's any cracking, peeling, anything like that going on. I mean, again, so far, everything looks excellent, very well put together, absolutely not any worse, if not better, than the factory build was. What I thought was actually interesting was with the heated element, for those of you that have it, there are actually these two wires, which you wouldn't, of course, see here, that sit underneath the bezel. And there's a connection that you have to separate when you're doing the new steering wheel. So what I was trying to figure out is, well, how did they do that factory? So when I took the bezel off, what I thought was fascinating is that the leather of the factory steering wheel underneath the bezel, those of you who know what I'm talking about, actually wasn't put together all that well. It almost looked like it was rushed. There were pieces coming off, like the bezel was basically just covering up kind of a, honestly, somewhat of a marginal job they did over here, hiding the heating element parts. Speaking of heating elements, when I disconnected it, I taped off the wires inside the steering wheel, and they were getting actually kind of in the way when putting the airbag back in. So you had to make sure that the heating element wiring was kind of in between the bracket that locks the airbag in and the actual airbag, almost like on the inside part underneath here. Like I can actually put my finger kind of back there and maybe even feel one of them sort of sitting there. I'll see if that ends up popping out or not. And the only other thing would be, and I haven't tested this yet because I don't want to throw some kind of code, would be to just see if for some reason, because I have no plans on using the heating steering wheel function, if for some reason you decided to still throw on that switch on the dash to activate it, if you get some type of error code, or, you know, check engine light, or if just nothing happens, would just be an interesting experiment. So the only other thing that I should probably mention, to me, it really isn't a big deal. It actually, I feel, adds grip on this wheel. But when you're, especially if you're a one-handed driver, you know, you got your left hand on 12 o'clock and you like to do the full turn with the wheel single-handed, if you're grabbing here where it's intended for kind of your thumb and between the index finger and thumb rest, if you spin the wheel over here, this edging kind of feels kind of not really sharp, but just maybe not quite as comfortable. So, you know, you don't get that like nice luxurious feel of rounded steering wheel. You just end up having to press the wheel around, but you're using this like weird feeling edge. Now, the good news is because this is perforated leather, you're not going to have slippage. Not that you have it even here. I mean, the coating on this carbon is amazing. But just thought I'd call that out. I mean, if I absolutely had to pick some kind of shortfall of this type of design, it maybe is that. But otherwise, I mean, it is just a great wheel. We've run it now for about a week. It's fantastic. Looks great, even kind of shimmers through the windshield from the outside, especially in the sunlight. It's not a head turner. I mean, a Durango is tinted out and on the front windshield, not everybody's going to see that necessarily, but still, mainly this is for personal enjoyment and that good feel. So hopefully you guys check this manufacturer out. Again, I thought it was a pretty good call. Appreciate you taking time to take a look. Thank you. So anyway, I appreciate you guys indulging this. I know some of you think that I sometimes tend to rant. You certainly are welcome to edit this out or fast forward, or maybe this provided no use, and that's totally fine. I just wanted to share a very unique steering wheel experience. I was really happy to have found this. So far, so great. Looking forward to seeing how it turns out in a few months. Thanks, y'all.